Well, joining me to discuss some parts of the president's speech is a social commentator, CG Adebi Beneth. Thank you very much for joining me at this time.
Thank you for having me, and happy independence.
Same to you, same to you. So looking at, let's talk about the issue of, first of all, how far have we gone between last year and now?
Not so far. We have not moved too far from where we were. But we are making some appreciable progress. We can say it's negligible. We're not where we want to be. But like I always say, we shouldn't just only focus on the negatives, but we should also focus on the positives, because you can't achieve much in an atmosphere of despondency. You can only, even the scripture says, a merry heart does good like medicine. So you can only do much when you are in a good state of mind. And so that's why so many times on social media, on conventional platforms, we try as much as possible to say, let's talk about the positives. Every country has some challenges. But when you talk about the positives, you leverage on the little positives you can see, while also making the government know that these challenges are still lingering, and so that we can really move forward.
So what will be the positives for you?
The government has, they have three core, let's say, program to that the campaign was based.
Yeah.
For anti-corruption, we've not seen much. The gains that were made, some of them were reversed because of court technicalities. And on the issue of economy, it's in a very bad state. Spokespersons for the government will tell you about the global crisis, the COVID, and now the war between Ukraine
and Russia.
It has affected, but because we also were in a situation that we're not supposed to be before that time, so it has escalated and it has affected us more.
And it is even more pronounced.
Yes. So the gains that we're supposed to even to make in our oil sector, we have not made it, and you can see the effect in the exchange rate between the naira and the dollar. And the third one, you know, economy, anti-corruption, and
agriculture.
No, the other one. Skip my mind now, but we'll get back there. So, but when you talk about infrastructural development, I don't think that's where the government is strong. There is a saying that it's people that are living that will make use of the infrastructure. But at the same time, the infrastructure also drive economic development. So we can see gains in infrastructure, the roads, transport, and the air system, air transportation, and see changes there. If you 4 years ago when I was at Port Harcourt International Airport, I told someone that the international should have been removed because you had to pass through canopies. Tents,
okay.
Just to, and it was an eyesore. So roads, transportation, something has been done. Then the rail system, something has been done.
Okay, so let's look at education now. We'll focus on the ASUU strike. Now, in his speech earlier, he called on ASUU to go back to the classrooms, despite the fact that some of the issues they have brought up have not been addressed by the government. What's your take on that?
I think that is a very big dent on the government. For me, the ASUU strike is not supposed to have lingered up until now. There is also a saying that nobody says no anywhere in the world, especially on issues that have to do with national development. I think the only thing the government should have, and when I mean the government, I'm not saying the Minister for Education, I'm not talking about the Labour Minister or the Junior Labour Minister, who can still be exuberant in some way. And this can cause conflict of interest. Because when you are trying to resolve an issue and you move two steps forward, and because of some utterances, then you move three steps back. The only thing the president should have done, for me, should have sat down personally with us. Lord Jonathan said something. That when the longest ASUU strike during his own term or regime, he sat down 14 hours with us and they trashed it. If a president sits down with you, I don't think you will get out of the meeting and go out and say an ASUU strike continues. I don't think it's possible. Let them show sincerity. You are the father of the nation. Spend some time. Let the ASUU president, the president, and every stakeholder sit down. This is our situation. I've listened to ASUU. They have their very strong points and positions. But I'm still an advocate of, we cannot continue like this. Okay. ASUU strike will continue as far as the university system is run the way it's been run.
Okay. So the president also talked about the 2023 elections, and this will be his last October 1st speech as a president. Now, he talked about delivering inclusive electoral process and tasking candidates on issue-based campaigns.
On elections, if you want to be fair to the government, they've tried a bit. We can see, I think it was reported on this station sometimes ago, that the number of elections the opposition has won within its term is much more than the ones the
previous ruling administration. Party. Okay, the ruling party has won. Okay.
The only difference is when the opposition wins, by virtue of their own internal wranglings, they deport back or put back to the ruling party. So you have so many of them, like the Imo State Governor, like the Cross River State Governor, like the Zamfara State Governor, coming back to the ruling party or porting to the ruling party, because some of them were never in the ruling party anyway. So these are the things. You will see the gains. We just saw Oshun. There was no manipulation in terms of from polling units to collation center because of what INEC has introduced. And there is nothing the president will do for you once you lose an election. Because before you even say Jack, he will have congratulated the person that was announced. Mm. So in terms, then, don't forget about the electoral law. Yeah. You can say so many things about him. But there are some things that have been put in place that have made election manipulation to be very difficult in Nigeria. So we have made some gains. The only challenge he has is the economy. Nobody wants to see those. Nobody's thinking about those games. And nobody is thinking about, 90% of Nigerians don't know, I stand to be corrected, don't know what's happening in the global world. They just know that we are having issues in Nigeria. Nothing concerns them if it's
especially similar. As the price of goods keeps skyrocketing on a daily basis.
It's happening everywhere. Mm. But I don't care if it's happening even in the US or the UK. People want to know what's happening to them in their own country. And don't forget that even when it's happening in those climes, there are palliative measures that get to everybody. UK is planning to offer every household £400 to £500 just because of winter, because of energy crisis. When the last 3 or 4 months, they gave everybody almost £150 to £250, energy palliative rebate. But when you want to do that in Nigeria, see the palliative we wanted to share. So those are the issues. Because they know that the citizens, when they rise in those places, there are laws. There is no way you can curb them forcefully.
Okay.
So these are the things we have to look at. On the economy and security. Security was the third.
That's what he talked about.
Yes,
as well.
I was going to talk about. Security, if we also want to be fair, from reports in the Northeast, even UN representatives, the Northeast is far, far better than how he met it.
Okay.
But another issue I've risen up in the Northwest, now going to the North Central, which is banditry. And people have said, now we can see what's happening there, shelling them every day. But you've left it too late.
Okay. All right. For want of time, we would have had this discussion in a bit longer. Well, thank you very much, and social commentator CJ Adebi Bennett for talking to us.
Thank you for having me. Beautiful.